Hello students, welcome back to your video class. Today we are going to study your second chapter, The Adventures of Toto, and written by Ruskin Bond. In this chapter we will know how a pet animal, when we keep at home, it becomes dangerous sometimes, it becomes very adventurous, or sometimes we have to send it to out of house. And so in this chapter we are going to read about Toto. Toto is the name of a small monkey, and how the author tells the story of Toto. So have you ever had any animal, any pet animal at home? Is there any animal as a pet at your house, like any dog, a rabbit, a deer, or sometimes people pet, you know, cat, or sometimes any other animal except you know, cow and buffaloes. So these animals, when we live with our family, we live with us, they become our family members and become very close. So this becomes very difficult for us to live away from them, and sometimes we love them very much. So in this chapter the author is talking about a monkey, and his name is Toto. So how he does the adventurous activities, fearless activities. So here we go. Have you ever had a baby monkey as a pet? So you must see the monkeys when you go on hill stations, when you go to mountains and you go to forest, there you see monkey. And you must have heard about the monkey, that monkey is such an animal which can copy the activities of humans. And this is the history of the humans, that we have from the generation to generations, human beings at this today's present life has come from the monkeys. So how a monkey does activities, you know very well, and you must have heard a story, a monkey and cap seller story. So if you tease any monkey, if you make any mischievous with any monkey, he can bite you, he can scratch you with his nails, and can harm you. So in this story also, people sometimes keep monkeys at home as pet animal, but it becomes very dangerous sometimes. So let's read in this chapter how Toto does the work of adventurous life. So Toto is a baby monkey, a small monkey. Let's find out whether he is mischievous or dully. Mischievous or dully, it's very simple. So here we go. Grandfather bought Toto from a tonga driver for the sum of 5 rupees. The author says that his grandfather bought Toto from a tonga driver. You see in the street sometimes people carry the monkeys to make the children happy, and they make the show corner to corner in the small villages, and they earn money from the people by showing that magic and the game of monkey. And this is an earning source for them. So grandfather bought Toto from a tonga driver for the sum of 5 rupees. The Chonga driver used to keep the little red monkey tied to his feeding trough, and the monkey looked so out of place there that grandfather decided he would add the little fellow to his private zoo. So a Chonga driver, he used to keep that little red monkey tied to a feeding trough at a place, and the monkey looked so out of place, means he was not feeling there comfortable, and grandfather decided that he would add the little fellow to his private zoo. Grandfather had a private zoo. Sometimes people make a small zoo at home. They keep they keep duck, rabbit, sparrows, and parrot. Many people keep parrot, cat, dog, and small puppies. So small type of private zoo they make at home. Toto was a pretty monkey. His bright eyes sparkled with mischief. Sparkled means brightened with mischief. Doing something unusual thing with others. Beneath deep set eyebrows and his teeth, which were pearly white, you must have seen pearl, the white pearl, this type of pearl. So his teeth were pearly white, were very often displayed in a smile. And you might see the monkeys, when you go near, they show their pearly white teeth. And that frightened the life out of elderly Anglo-Indian ladies. So the Indian ladies who used to live out of India. So he was very fearful for them. But his hands looked dried up, very dried up, as though they had been pickled in the sun for many years. And his eyes were bright, very sparkling. Features, how did Toto look? So you can say that his eyes were sparkled and bright, and his teeth were pearly white, and his hands were dried up, though had been pickled in the sun for many years. Like in the sun, if you put anything for long years, for many years, it will become very dried. Yet his fingers were quick and wicked, very quick and wicked. You know, monkey is very active animal, not lazy. So can jump here to there in seconds. And his tail, you see tail, with the help of tail, he can swing from one tree to the other tree. How he enjoys from this tree to that tree. While adding to his good looks, and his tail really added beauty to his body. Grandfather believed a tail would add to anyone's good looks. So he used to think that if one has tail, then it would add beauty, good looks. Also served as third hand, and obviously the tail of a monkey helps like a third hand. Because with the help of tail, a monkey can hang to the trees, branches easily without holding with hands. You can see them when you go to the hill stations. You can see how they jump, and they just roll the tail around the branches, and how they hang. They enjoy everything. And he could use it to hang from a branch, obviously, and it was capable of scooping up any delicacy that might be out of reach of his hands, and easily he could, you know, get the things if his hand is not reaching to that place. Then he could use his tail, and with the help of tail he could hang to the branches and could get the thing out of reach, out of his hands, he could get easily. Grandmother always fussed is a word, fussing means making trouble, like getting angry. Grandmother always fussed when grandfather brought home some new bird or animal. And sometimes we see that all family members do not like the animals. If one or two family members like animals, they bring home those animals, then there is a big fuss at home, quarrel at home. So grandfather bought Toto from a Tonga driver for the sum of 5 rupees only. 5 rupees he paid for the monkey. But at home, granny, you know, grandmother, how she treats when she is not in favor of anything you see at home. So grandmother always fussed when grandfather brought home some new bird or animal. So whenever grandfather brought any animal at home, any new bird, any new animal, grandmother always quarreled, made fuss at home. So it was decided that Toto's presence should be kept a secret from her until she was in a particularly good mood. So the author says that, so we decided that we will not tell grandmother about Toto, about the monkey, that we have brought this monkey at home. So we will keep him a secret until the mood of granny, mood of the grandmother is normal. Sometimes when the things all of sudden you put in front of anyone, then, you know, can burst into anger. So it was decided that we will keep Toto secret. Secretly we will keep somewhere in the house, and we will wait for granny's mood to be normal. Grandfather and I put him away in a little closet opening into my bedroom wall. So there was a closet like almira in the bedroom wall. So we decided to put him there secretly without telling grandmother, where he was tied securely, very safely, or so we thought, to a peg fastened into the wall. So he was, peg is like small peg we just throw in wall to tie something, to hang something, a small peg like a small stick we push into the wall. So we decided that to a peg fastened into the wall, so we can tie the monkey to the peg. Few hours later, when we brought the monkey, Toto, few hours later of that, when grandfather and I came back to release Toto, we found that the walls, which had been covered with some ornamental paper chosen by the grandfather, now stood out as naked brick and plaster. The peg in the wall had been wrenched from its socket, and my school blazer, which had been hanging there, was in shreds. Oh, really very bad happened. What happened? Grandfather and I, means the author, hid that monkey in his bedroom. So there was a closet, a small almira in the wall. So there they put the monkey and they tied it with a peg in the wall, and they went away. Means after few hours, like after 3-4 hours, when they came back, how the monkey had made the thing, the room, from all the sides, I tell you. We found the walls which had been covered with some ornamental paper. So they had pasted papers all around the wall, ornamental paper to decorate the room. Sometimes we paste ornamental paper to decorate the wall. So Toto had torn all the papers from the wall, and they could see brick and plaster on the wall very easily. And the peg in the wall, which they hit, the peg in the wall they fixed, had been wrenched from its socket, and he pulled out the peg also. And my school blazer, the author is telling the story when he was a small child. So my school blazer, it's when you go to school, you wear a blazer, so which had been hanging there in that room where they tied the Toto, was in shreds. Shreds means it was torn to pieces, small pieces. Because monkey can bite the cloth easily with the very sharp teeth. I was shocked, surprised, what grandmother would say now, and feared, really scared. But grandfather did not worry. He seemed pleased with Toto's performance, and he was happy. Grandfather became happy that Toto had done all this. He just torn the whole pages, paper, golden paper from the walls, and torn the blazer and put things here and there in the room. Even then, grandfather was pleased, very happy to see Toto's performance. He is clever, said grandfather. Given time, I am sure he could have tied the torn pieces of blazer into a rope and made his escape from the window. And he made a fun that now you know what he would do. With your torn blazer, very soon he would make the rope from the pieces of your blazer. He would make a rope, a strong rope, and with the help of that rope, he would make escape from the window. He will jump out of the window, and he's very clever. And obviously monkeys are very clever, really. His presence in the house still a secret, but his presence was still a secret because we did not tell anyone in the house. Toto was now transferred to a big cage in the servants' quarters. So we shifted Toto to a big cage in servants' quarters. So where the servants used to live in the house, in those quarters we shifted Toto, where a number of grandfather's pets lived very sociably together, where other animals of grandfather lived sociably together, like a tortoise, tortoise. People, you know, rear tortoise at home. A tortoise, a pair of rabbits, these animals were in the private zoo of grandfather. A tame squirrel also, squeal, beautiful squeal. And for a while my pet goat, one goat. But the monkey would not allow any of his companions to sleep at night. So So grandfather, who had to leave Dehradun next day to collect his pension in Saharanpur, decided to take him along. So there was a problem. Grandfather thought that if we leave this monkey in the zoo, so this monkey will make mischief and it will not let the other animals sleep at night. So grandfather had to go out of station to collect his pension in Saharanpur. So he decided to take monkey with him to Saharanpur. So he took monkey to Saharanpur with him. Unfortunately, I could not accompany grandfather on that trip. I was not with him that day, unfortunately. But he told me about afterwards. He told me the story afterwards. And let's see what happened on the way when grandfather took monkey to Saharanpur, what he told. A big black canvas kit bag was provided for Toto. So how he could take Toto to the other place, we cannot keep pet animals in the buses, trains, public transportations without ticket, and we have to get the permission also for that. So a black big canvas kit bag was prepared for Toto, and this with some straw at the bottom. So they prepared a small bag, and at the bottom we put some straw, some grass, dry grass, and became his new abode. Abode is a place where anyone lives, abode, a place to dwell. When the bag was closed, there was no escape. No escape means no any place to come out. No escape. Toto could not get his hands through the opening. And the canvas was too strong for him to bite his way through. And the canvas was very strong. And we have very thick canvas. So it was not easy for Toto to bite that canvas easily. And his efforts to get out only had the effect of making the bag roll about on the floor or occasionally jump into the air. So what he could do, in the bag they packed, so he could not take out his hands out from the bag. So he could do what? He could roll the bag here and there, or sometimes can jump in the air. Only that he could do, nothing else. An exhibition that attracted a curious crowd of onlookers on a Dehradun railway platform. And in this way we took him to the air, to the railway station at the platform. People were ongoing, onlookers, the people who were passing by, onlookers. So they were looking, and it was kind of exhibition. Anyone who was passing by that way could see that monkey in the bag, and it was made like exhibition, and attracted the attention of crowd at Dehradun railway platform. Toto remained in the bag as far as Saharanpur. So Toto remained in the bag. The grandfather had to go to Saharanpur. But while grandfather was producing his ticket at the railway turnstile, turnstile is a gate. When you pass that gate and it's a revolving, one person can pass at a time, such type of revolving door you can see at the parks and such places. So was producing his ticket, was showing his ticket. Toto suddenly poked his head out of the bag. And suddenly Toto poked out his head out of the bag and gave the ticket collector a wide grin. He gave the ticket collector wide grin, very wide, sometimes the monkeys make the sound of creak, like very creak. Oh, the poor man was taken aback, surprised. It's a phrase, taken aback. Surprised, but with great presence of mind and much to grandfather's annoyance, he said, "Sir, you have a dog with you. You will have to pay for it accordingly." And with great presence of mind and much to grandfather's annoyance. Grandfather's annoyance means like making angry. So he said, "Sir, you have a dog with you." Because by the time monkey was inside the bag, only he could see the face. "And you will have to pay for it accordingly. And I told you that when you travel with your animal, you have to get a ticket for animals also. You cannot travel otherwise." So in vain did grandfather take Toto out of the bag. In vain did he try to prove that a monkey did not qualify as a dog or even as a quadruped. Toto was classified a dog by the ticket collector, and 3 rupees was the sum handed over as his fare. He had to pay 3 rupees. So grandfather tried to convince and took out Toto out of the bag, and he proved that this was not a dog, it was a monkey. And he tried, but he could not qualify, and Toto was classified a dog by the ticket collector. But the ticket collector said, "No, this is a dog and you will have to pay for it." And grandfather had to pay 3 rupees as fare. Then grandfather, just to get his own back on back, took from his pocket our pet tortoise and said, on back means just to take, tit for tat. So he took from his pocket our pet tortoise. He took out, and grandfather took his tortoise in the pocket, in the coat pocket. So he took out tortoise and said, "What must I pay for this, since you charge for all animals?" He asked to the ticket collector that, "What I have to pay for this now, tortoise, because since you charge for all animals." The ticket collector looked closely at the tortoise, prodded it with his forefinger, prodded like dust, gave grandfather a pleased and triumphant look, victory look, and said, "No charge, it's not a dog, no charge." So when Toto was finally accepted by grandmother, he was given a comfortable home in the stable where we keep the animals. So this way the journey was over, and when grandmother accepted Toto in the family, in the private zoo, in the beginning grandmother did not like Toto, but later she accepted and given a comfortable home in the stable, where he had for a companion the family donkey Nana, and on Toto's first night in the stable, grandfather paid him a visit to see if he was comfortable. To his surprise, he found Nana, without apparent cause, pulling at her halter and trying to keep her head as far as possible from a bundle of hay. So he was kept in the stable where we keep the other animals. So the monkey was kept there, and it was the first night. So grandfather paid a visit to check whether he was comfortable, and to his surprise he found Nana, means donkey, name of donkey Nana, without apparent cause, without any cause, pulling at her halter where we tie the animals, and trying to keep her head as far as possible from a bundle of hay. A bundle of hay, bundle of grass, you can say. He was trying to pulling his head away from that bundle of grass or hay. Grandfather gave Nana a slap across her haunches, and she jerked back, jerked with a quick jerk, dragging Toto with her. It's dragging Toto with her, with a jerk, with a sudden jerk. She jerked back, moved back, and dragging Toto with her. He had fastened on to her long ears with his sharp little teeth. And it was a little monkey, so what Toto did that he had fastened, stuck on to her long ears with his sharp little teeth. Toto had fastened himself with Nana, donkey's long ears. Toto and Nana never became friends. They always remained enemy. They could not become friends. The monkey and the donkey never can become. So a great treat for so they never became friends. So students, this is the half chapter we have read so far, and some new words I have written here on the board. You can search in the dictionary if you have not understood. So this way, how grandfather brought a monkey from a Tonga driver with the sum of 5 rupees, and how he kept secretly, because the grandmother did not like monkey, so they kept in the room. And the first day Toto scattered all the paintings and the canvas and papers in the bedroom, so they decided to keep him secretly with the private zoo. But their grandfather thought that he would not let other animals sleep at night. So by the time grandfather had to go to Saharanpur, and he took Toto with him on the way, what happened? He had to pay 3 rupees for Toto, because the ticket collector classified him as a dog. So this way, and finally they brought Toto in the stable where a donkey named Nana already lived there. So Toto and Nana, they both always fought with each other, remained enemy, and we'll continue with this story, and let's see how Toto does other adventures in this story. We'll enjoy by the time you read and find the new words which you find difficult to understand, and have a good reading and enjoy. We'll continue in your next class. We'll see how Toto does the other adventures. Thank you so much. Have good time.